Good morning, YouTube. You're back with Brenda Lee. You don't know who Brenda Lee is? You can go fuck yourself. Brenda Lee's convenience or goodies shop and go, where the gas prices are always high and the cigarettes are always cheap. Cheaper than me, honey, and that's a guarantee. So, I'm just gonna cut to the chase and I'm gonna get it all out now because I'm gonna tell you something that these TikTok gurus, these YouTube fuckwits, and these Facebook fuckboys don't want you to know, okay? Because they're trying to sell you some serum, some supplements, some pills that are probably just gonna give you raging fucking diarrhea and a skin rash and gonorrhea. So what I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna tell you this right now, this is free of charge from your auntie Brenda fucking Lee, is that nobody has anything figured out. Nobody, not your mom, not your dad, not your grandpa, not your grandma. Everybody is literally just guessing at everything that they are doing. Now you might look at me and think, Brenda Lee, you are an accomplished, successful small business owner. You got it figured out. You make your own hours. You do what you want. You don't worry about consequences. Well, that's not entirely true. You know what? It may look like I have it all figured out. It may look like I have it all, whatever the fuck that means. I literally have nothing. This isn't even my house. But I'm also worried about my dog dying. I also worry about renewing my license in a year. I'm worried about monkeypox. I'm worried about regular pox. I'm worried about the fact that there is polio. Polio! We have polio, guys. We got measles, we got the mumps, we got the polio, we got the monkeypox, we got that COVID. We got all the variants too. You know, do you want large, small, medium? You know, we got it all. We got it all. And it's just stop putting so much fucking pressure on yourself to have it all figured out, to have the secret of life in your back fucking pocket, because nobody has that. You know why? Because it doesn't exist. It does not exist. It is a lie made up by people who sell books, who sell supplements, who again are going to give you probably a rash, gonorrhea, and diarrhea. It's going to give you all the ears, but nobody has it figured out. It's not putting so much pressure on yourself to be perfect, because that also does not exist. You know, there's so many people who are just running through life and they're like, oh, I'm in the rat race, I'm in the cubicle farm, I'm in this farm, I'm in that farm. But you know, we're all in the same person farm, and you know, sometimes the farm is going to give you a little treat, you know, ooh. Take this. But you know, at the end of the day, we're all just trying to do the best that we can with the tools that we have, with the little time that we have on this planet. And that's all you can do. So stop putting so much pressure on yourself. You're doing great. You're doing fine. Yes, you got bills to pay. Yes, you probably got kids. Yeah, you're watching your parents age and they're gonna get old and die one day. And it's really fucking sad. And nobody tells you how to deal with that. Nobody, there's no book. there are books, but you have to pay for it. And you're already paying the medical bills and you're already driving them to work and you're already taking them to doctor's appointments. You ain't got time to read a book, but nobody tells you how to deal with that shit. Nobody tells you what it's like to sit in the doctor's office with your mother while she tells all of her personal private details to your doctor. Nobody prepares you for that. So I'm here to tell you, relax. Take a load off. Don't forget to treat yourself too, because in this wild, wacky, zany, wibbly wobbly world of ours, we always forget about us because we're always taking care of the other people. And that's okay. It's okay to be a giver. It's okay to be a caretaker. There's nothing wrong with that. But who's taking care of you, bitch? Who's taking care of your ass? Who's dicking you down? Do you have a vibrator? Do you got pills? Do you, I mean, like for headaches and shit like that. I mean, if you got pills, share them. I'll take the Quaaludes. But I'm just saying, smoke a bowl every now and then. Get a little back massage thing. I don't know. Just lay down and take a fucking nap because it feels good. I get what it's like to be exhausted. Everybody's fucking exhausted right now. And I know that sometimes you'll be like, well, I'm exhausted, but so is everybody else. So why should I complain? Bitch, you have every right to fucking complain because it's scary out there. It's exhausting out there. But I want you to do a favor for your Auntie Brenda fucking Lee. I want you to go do your hair. I want you to do your nails. I want you to do your makeup. I want you to do whatever it is that makes you feel good. You know, whatever it is that makes you feel happy. If it's, you know, going and being with your friends. If it's staying home and being around nobody and watching a fucking Princess Diana documentary that's literally like every other Princess fucking Diana documentary. That's what I'm doing with my afternoon. Then do that. If you like crafting, make something. If you haven't made something in a while, do it. If you haven't fucked in a while, go and do it. But be careful because monkeypox is a thing and so is COVID-19. And so are other sexually transmitted diseases. So please be careful. Please be safe. But if you want to go and do it, go and fucking do it. I don't fucking care. I just want you to be safe. And I want you to just be happy. That's all I want. There's not enough happy. There's not enough fucking happy. Because everybody's so worried about making other people happy that they forget about themselves. And you need to prioritize you. you. So if there's something that you love and there's something that you enjoy, whether it's fucking Snickers bars, gummy bears, Swiss cake rolls, I don't fucking know, I don't fucking, whatever. Whatever your bag is, baby, why don't you go and do it? You know, unless you're a fucking psychopathic serial killer, in which case you really should turn yourself in. Just to circle back again really quick, nobody has all the answers and we're all just fumbling around trying to figure things out. 95% of adulthood is literally guesswork. Literally, I can't keep doing the Brenda Lee thing. She's not sticking around. Brenda Lee's taken off for a little bit. But nobody has all the answers. This is Lily now coming at you. I just keep seeing all of this stuff on YouTube and on Twitter and even on Instagram of people being like, why don't I have it all figured out? Why don't I have this? Why don't I have that? And honestly, it is from a lot of people who are in their late teens and early 20s. I don't want to come off as that condescending adult. Because something that I hated when I was younger was people being like, you're too young, you don't know everything, blah, blah, blah. It's so annoying. And I know it's really condescending and fucking annoying, but it's true. But you know what's also something that adults also will not tell you while they're telling you you don't know everything? That yes, while more adults have more life experience, because that just fucking happens with age, we also don't know everything. We know nothing. Yeah, I have a 9-to-5 job. I work Monday through Friday. I have health insurance. I have benefits. And I'm so abundantly grateful that I can now feel comfortable taking care of the shit that I needed and neglected to take care of when I was in my early 20s. But yeah, I am still worried about my dog dying. I'm still worrying about renewing my license. That's something that Brendan Lee and I share. And I am watching my parents age. And it's horrible. It's so horrible and I don't know how to deal with it. I genuinely have no idea how to deal with all of it. It's really hard. I'm scared and I am exhausted. But today I did my nails, which felt really nice. My dog got her nails done, which was also great. She hated it, but you know, it needed to be done, which I felt really good about. I got a load of laundry I need to do and I went and got myself a haircut because I was like, fuck it, I wanna go get a nice haircut. And I know not everybody has the means to treat themselves in ways like this, but please remember to take care of yourself. And please remember, nobody has it figured out. There is no secret. There's absolutely no secret. Someone's trying to sell you a secret. If someone's putting a price tag on a secret, it's not real. It's not real. The secret is within you, which is, I think, what the book The Secret is about. The secret's just really, well, whatever the fuck. But you still have to buy a book to figure that out, which really pisses me off. I hate gurus. If you were a real guru, if you were a real psychic and shit, you wouldn't be charging a bitch. You would be wanting to spread that for free. You would be wanting to give that away so that all mankind can benefit from your secrets. But you don't have any. You have none. And it pisses me off when I see shit like that. And I hate seeing my friends and I hate seeing people I care about get taken advantage of and get pulled in by this shit. It's all lies. People are just trying to make money off of lonely, sad people. And those are the people who need us the most. Who need the help the most. The people who are at the... I'm rereading a diary from 2017 and I was the girl who needed help the most. I fucking hate online gurus. That they're a bunch of fucking charlatans, fucking snake oil salesmen, and they can all bite my ass. So remember, if someone on the internet is trying to sell you the secret of life, the secret serum, the fucking fountain of youth shit, it's not real. There's a very great line from a wonderful fucking movie. Life is pain. Anyone who tells you different is selling something. And that's 100% true. Life is about endurance. Life is pain. Life is frustrating and complicated. And human beings are these complex individuals that will disappoint you one moment and then be like, wow, why couldn't you have been greater like you were 20 fucking years ago? And it's just so annoying. And I hate it. But here we are and here we stand. And this is what we have. We do the best you can with the little time that you have on this planet. And hopefully don't fuck anybody over in the process on purpose. Sometimes you fuck people over and don't even mean to. Because that's life. That's life. It's just that. There you go. There's another secret to life. Sometimes you fuck people over and you don't even mean to. Yeah, this is just a little rant. This is just a little quick Brenda Lee thing. You know, got some shit thrown in there. And, you know, just, I just hate seeing good people taken advantage of. I hate seeing, and it's not because people are stupid. It's because people are vulnerable and put themselves out there. And then these snake oil salesmen take advantage of that. And I don't fucking like it. You know, I just don't. It's disgusting. Horrible. But yeah, this has just been a little rant. We haven't had a rant video in a few years, I feel like. And I used to do them all the time. But yeah, so yeah, the secret of life, you wouldn't fucking sell it. So fucking blow me. But yeah, thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. Peace and long life. And stay tuned and turned on for more.